Spring in Turkey's largest city is also the season of motion pictures. For 38 years, the International Istanbul Film Festival has been providing Istanbulites with a wide variety of engaging movies in the month of April. And this year's edition offers more than just films. In a surprising move, the festival decided to hold the second season premiere of the Turkish Netflix production, The Protector. The other important event at the festival marks the debut screening of master movie maker Stanley Kubrick's first ever feature film, Fear and Desire. For a long time, the movie was only available on bootleg VHS tapes, since it was believed that Kubrick had destroyed the feature's original negative. Now to unpack the 38th edition of the International Istanbul Film Festival is Festival Director Kerem Ayan. Hi Kerem, thank you so much for being with us today.
Hi.
So let's start with the poster of the festival. This is very Kubrick inspired to me.
Yes.
Tell me about the focus on Stanley Kubrick this
year. We are showing all the 13 films of Stanley Kubrick, including his first one, Fear and Desire, which he hated a bit. He doesn't want this film to be shown, but it makes part of his retrospective, so we are showing it. And we did this poster as an homage to Clockwork Orange, as you see, by the artist Sebastian Janiek.
Mm-hmm. And everyone thought that Fear and Desire, the first copy, was destroyed, right?
Yeah, but I mean, they did a restored copy of it. Now they are showing in festivals, and we wanted to include also in the festival.
Mm-hmm. And let's talk a bit more about the selection. Mm. One thing that caught everyone's eye was the number of female directors in the national competition. Mm-hmm. There is only one, right?
Yes.
How did that happen? Do you think it's surprising? I mean, looking at the previous years of Istanbul Film Festival?
Well, it was a bit surprising for us also, because we didn't have any... there was only one film that applied, you know, to the festival with two female directors. It's a problem, of course, in Turkey, but also in the world, you know, this problem. We will do also a panel on this subject. And I think some things should be done about this matter, because we have, for example, in our meetings on the bridge section, we have of the 13 projects, we have 8 female director projects. So it will be really good if these projects will go on and we can see them as movies in the next editions of the festival.
Mm-hmm. And big festivals, yeah, like Venice, Cannes, Berlinale, they unveiled a gender parity pledge, mm-hmm, in the last few years, I'd say, in order to improve women's representation in the cinema world. Do you think Istanbul Film Festival will be a part of it?
So far, no. But the thing is, I think it's more of a producing problem than a festival problem. We need to have more films so that we can choose from them, you know, because sometimes they push a bit too much, you know, just to put female directors' movies. They are sometimes taking the films that are not that good, you know, so we need to have quality films from all directors so that we can choose it. We can choose from them, you know, so I think, as I said, it's more a producing problem. So we are waiting for new films from female directors and, of course, other directors also.
Mm-hmm. And Netflix.
Yes.
This comes very often to you, I believe. You are screening Netflix's first original Turkish TV series, mm-hmm, The Protector.
Yeah.
And this has been a hot debate, really. I mean, is it the first time in a movie festival, film festival, for this kind of production to be screened?
No, of course not. Before, Cannes and Berlin did these kinds of things, even I think Venice maybe, because the series production is becoming more and more important in the world today. So Netflix proposed us to show this documentary, this series, and then we were interested because the second season starts at the end of April, so it's very close, and the whole team will be there. So it's really interesting for us also to show this different part of the cinema, which are series. Mm-hmm.
And also, I think a lot of the film festivals at the moment are quite reactionary against Netflix. For example, Cannes. What is Istanbul Film Festival?
We are not.
I can see that.
No, but really, I mean, I think we can exist, you know, with Netflix and the festivals. They can exist together. I think Cannes reaction was a bit too much at the beginning. Of course, we want to see films in big screen as festivals, but things are changing, you know, slowly. Netflix is a very new company, you know. They are learning, we are learning. You know, for example, we started last year with Roma, Alfonso Cuarón movie. It was a Netflix movie, then we showed it on big screen. It went very well. And then the film was released also in the world. And now this year we are showing two other Netflix movies in the festivals. So I think we are learning to live together and the world is changing. So we have to adapt to this new kind of movie making also. You know, for example, Scorsese did his last movie with Netflix, you know. So it's okay. I think we will do together some good things.
And we will see more of Netflix in the future,
I assume.
Kerem Ayan, the director of International Istanbul Film Festival, thank you so much for joining us today and delving into this year's program with us.
Thank you.